Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Kiki Fontenot with the LSU AgCenter, and today I wanted to give you guys some information about covering your crops in colder weather. So we all know that we're about to have some cooler weather coming in where the temperatures are going to be, or are predicted to go below 32, up, you know, down to even 25 in some cases. That's really important for certain crops, but not others, knowing that information. So if you have a vegetable garden at home and you've got all your cool season crops out there, like carrots or turnips or cabbage or broccoli or any of those kind of things, think leafy greens or root crops, they are going to be fine. You do not need to cover those. Now your broccoli and cauliflower may get a little purple color tinge to them, but they're going to live. They're going to survive. We have other crops like these blueberries that I'm standing next to right now and strawberries, okay? Those are crops that we plant in the fall or in the cool season, but we usually get that crop or harvest it in the spring. So these are going to be examples of tender crops that you're going to need to focus on covering at your house if you're growing them. Now, if you're growing rabbit eye blueberries, those are blueberries that usually produce a little later for us. Some may have a few blooms on them now. Most of them aren't blooming. They're going to be just fine. But here I'm standing next to our southern high bush blueberry trial. These are evergreen type blueberries and they produce a lot earlier. Commercial producers in Louisiana grow these. A few of you home gardeners might have Jewel or Star. You know, those are a little bit more popular varieties of these southern high bush blueberries. And these, as you can see standing next to me, are definitely in bloom right now. And if you look closer on some of the shrubs, we have fruit on these, and in some cases even some blue fruit already. So we're going to be harvesting next week. This is not something that I feel comfortable leaving exposed if the temperatures are going to drop below 32. So I'm going to do a couple things in preparation before I cover them. The first thing, and why I have dirty fingernails, is because we've gone through and we've weeded out our pots. We let these pots get a little weedy. Insects harbor in weeds, so I'm trying to remove those weeds. The second thing I'm going to do before I cover, and this isn't necessary all the time, but I like doing it, is I'm going to spray ultra fine oil, okay? Why I'm doing this is when we start putting on covers, whether it's your white bed sheet or it's the Agrabond that I'm using here today, any kind of cover like a blanket for temperatures, you can build up populations of mites and thrips underneath them very quickly because the natural predators aren't coming in to eat them. So I'm going to try, if there's anything out there that I can't see, I'm going to go ahead and coat it with the oil and smother it out, okay? Next, I'm going to grab my weather protection cloth. And as you guys can see here, I've got a lot of blueberries to cover. So I ordered some big rolls of this. You can go down to your local hardware store, okay, or your local plant nursery and find this. If we look close, it's almost a see-through white fabric, like a blanket. Now, depending on the weight or the type that you get, it'll protect you anywhere from like 2 up to 8 degrees. The heavier the cloth, the more expensive it is. What I'm using today is Agrabond 30, and this is gonna give me 4 to 6 degrees of protection. So if we get down to 25, I'm hoping we're still in the low 30s there. You see what I'm saying? I don't wanna drop these too low. What we're showing right now is covering the blueberries with the Agrabond or with the weather protection cloth that you guys will get at the hardware store. So here it is, and you can see we go from one side of the plants all the way to the other. You want to leave it long enough on both sides so that you can go ahead and cover it with something, anchor it down at your house. Here we're using T-posts, but if you have sandbags, bricks, cinder blocks, whatever you have, I've even seen people do it with like those Tonka truck toys, whatever you have laying around your house to keep that Agrabond down or that weather cloth down. Now, we're gonna go all the way down with our blueberries here, but we're not leaving it open like as a tunnel like you see right here. At the end, we're gonna come and we're gonna put another piece of cloth covering both ends of our row to make it completely sealed to keep our blueberries safe and warm this weekend.